And so we formed a statewide campaign committee with representatives of as many different organizations, kind of stakeholders in the issue, and some key individuals as well, and hired a guy named Doug Gray, a political consultant from Kansas City, to be the chair of the operation. I was the vice chair and the treasurer working from here. And we set about trying to educate the community about it. We did polling, which at the very beginning, the polling showed that it had widespread support. The effort to ban same-sex marriage had widespread support in Missouri. In fact, the only toehold that we had that changed people's minds at all was the fact that it was a constitutional amendment as opposed to just a law. So the campaign committee was called the Constitution Defense League. But it was a big effort. I mean, we had a big campaign office, donated space, in the loop, and lots and lots of volunteers, and they were going door to door and talking about our lives, and there was a difference. And when we, the election night when we lost, it was like 70-30. It was a very, very lopsided, but we had a election night party at this new place in the Grove. This was back before it became the Grove, but it was a restaurant owned by somebody, a gay guy in the community. I gave a speech, and really the best takeaway from it we could come up with is that, based on the campaign work that we did of identifying supporters, is that we now could identify supporters of, we could identify supporters of and gay people in every single legislative district in the state. So never again would we have to hear from a legislator, well, I don't know anybody in my district who supports this, because we knew that we had people there. That was our positive takeaway from it. But obviously it was demoralizing. That's when you spend so much time and energy and effort and sleepless nights and long days and money to please let us have this element of dignity. It's a rough go.